being a wild Tubi fan, but we got the Wolf back in action, 11 plus, still on 60 volt, running a thumb throttle now, which is kind of suckful. So you can see there, 67. Added a Flipsky non-vesk 75-100 dual ESC in there. That's why I'm running the thumb throttle. This one has no app unlike a vesk. I got USB broken out for laptop programming. I've got brake hooked up, HPFI on the rear, and IPDS on the front. So the rear is stronger and more noisy. So when I hit the brake, it's pretty noisy. But just going for a test run. I got 30 amps regen on the brake, and that seems to be good enough to slow me down this hill. See, I just tapped the brake. You can hear it coming on. Front wheel losing air. Yeah, that's fine. This has been out of action for a long time. The kind tires that I had on there, yeah, they didn't like sitting around doing nothing for a year. Whole throttle brake, because this button brake has a 1 second delay to turn off. It's flat. God damn it. Wonder why it does that. Well, I can't run the test now. but I've got a flat tire. Flat tire ruined the test. Oh well, we still go uphill. Uphill on the flat tire. That's a crazy load. So I've only got on the back brake lever. So when I hit the front, it doesn't do all that noisy shit. Crazy bumps with this flat front tire, the disc is gonna hit, so I can't even punch it. Crazy, cause my flat's flattening the rim. Stand on the back. Oh, I feel really bad fine. Resume the test run when I fix my front tire again. Okay, front bead repaired. Turns out it wasn't. Shut up. Turns out it wasn't anything. It was just old anti-puncture fibers that were dried up in there, causing the bead to be lumpy. So I just cleaned up the actual rim and put a little bit of oil in there to keep it moist, and then it seals up fine. Let's go.
the watering. I'm gonna need a full face helmet with a visor if I go above 60. By their eyeballs.
Set up some GPS action here.
We have lots of familiars out, so you gotta go slow until we get to the river. Hey. Yeah, this battery sat around for so long that it was at 45 volts when I started doing this ESC swap. So hopefully it's still okay. Feel like 100. Felt about 80. Oh, my face is sufficiently chilled. Holy shit. Whew. Look at the sun swirl getting stuck. That's dangerous. We're just abusing it to see if it overheats. It's got an aluminium case, aluminium PCB apparently, so. Got regen only set to 30 amps. Otherwise it's too crazy. Is so stable. Even I'm not ready. I just got tears streaming down my face right now. Cruise control because it's on the locks. Thank you. She's quick and smooth, even with the rougher HDFI on the back. You can hear it on a takeoff. Still got good traction. Phew! God damn. Guess we better check what the GPS is saying. Oh. Well, it didn't record my highest speed. That sucks. I'm gonna have to charge it back. Alright, we'll try that then. Into the wind. Oh, that wind is crazy. Crazy ass wind. .88 Marty McFly did. Oh, 99.1 with the 60 volt. Look out. Now that's what I'm talking about. You! And it was still winding out too. I just had to back off because I didn't know what that golden golf was doing at the intersection. You can never be too careful when it comes to other people. mile now.
.1. That's so good.
Too bad I can't wheelie this thing though. That fucking front wheel. I think it hit my disc on both ends. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, smashed my disc. Asshole. Oh well, it's still straight. Before it falls out. Spot is nice and warm, about 40 degrees, nothing crazy. Anyway, that's the Flipsky Dual Non-Vesk. You can get it for about $200 delivered, Australian. And yeah, wire it up, hook it up. All you need is your brake, a whole brake would be preferred, and the throttle. That's it. Well, hope you enjoyed that test run. So I've only hit 97, and I think that's 93 kilometers on GPS with the DualShock X2 controllers. But this was still winding out, and I hit 99.1. So yeah, nice. Yeah, hope you enjoyed that, and that's the wolf back in action.